Sampan from Aden Progressive School. Students, in my today's video, I'll explain you the second chapter from your Footprints Without Feet, that is the thief's story. This story is written by Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond, he is an Indian author of British descent. He was born in 19 May 1934. He was awarded Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 and Padma Shri in 1999 and Padma Bhushan in 2014. I think most of you must be familiar with this writer and you might have read his stories also. He is basically famous for writing the story for children. He is also famous for writing short stories and poems. The Indian Council of Child Education has recognized his role in the growth of children literature. So let's start the chapter. I'll explain you the story. Before the explanation, I'll tell you the theme of the story. The story is based on the fact that how the kindness and the love can change anybody's mind. So here in the story, the Hari Singh, he is a thief. He keeps on changing his name so that he can protect himself, so that he can escape from the police as well as his old employers. And here in this chapter, his name is Hari Singh, right? So, and he befriended with Anil in order to rob him. But later on, we find that Anil has changed his mind. How Anil changed his mind, that will read the story and I'll explain you the story.
In this story, basically there are only two characters. First is Hari Singh, the narrator, the thief. He is a 15-year-old fair-handed thief. He is a keen on learning how to read and write. He is so experienced robber that he knows how different people will react when they are robbed. And the second character is Anil. He is a 25-year-old tall and lean man. He earns his living by writing. He is a kind, simple and an easygoing person. Student, this is a beautiful story of a young thief who was able to reform his life after he started living with young man. So now I'll explain the entire story line by line. I was still a thief when I met Anil, and though only 15. So the narrator was a thief in the story. When he met Anil, he was 15 years old. I was an inexperienced and fairly successful hand. He was very experienced in his profession and fairly successful hand. Fairly successful hand means, it means whatever theft he was involved, he successfully stole the things. Anil was watching a wrestling match when I approached him. He was about 25, a tall, lean fellow. So the Anil, when the thief approached the Anil, when he reached the Anil, he was watching a wrestling match. And he was about 25 years and he was tall, lean fellow, he was thin and he looked easygoing. He was not looking strict, kind and simple enough for my purpose. So thief found him, he was very easygoing person, kind and simple enough for his purpose. What was his purpose? To steal the things. I hadn't had much luck of late and thought I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. The thief was saying that he hadn't had much luck of late. That means the narrator, the thief, didn't get any chance to steal the things in the recent days. And he thought he might be able to get into the young man's confidence. He wanted to be in the confidence of young men's. You look a bit of a wrestler yourself. So the narrator said to the Anil that he looks like a wrestler. I said, a little bit flattery helps in making friends. Because he wants to be a friend with Anil, so he started flattering. It means he started boasting to Anil. So do you. The same, he replied. The Anil replied, so do you. You also look like a wrestler. Which put me off for a moment because at that time I was rather thin. So he was surprised to get the reply from the Anil, because that time the thief was rather thin. Well, I said modestly, I do wrestle a bit. Then he replied with humbly, yes, I do wrestle a bit. What's your name? Hari Singh. So the Anil asked him, what is his name? So the thief replied, Hari Singh. I lied. I took a new name every month. The thief spoke lie. He changed his name every month. Why did he change his name every month? That kept me ahead of the police and my former employers. Because so that he always changed his name. Every month he changed his name so that he could escape from the police and the former employers where he did the stealing. They could not catch him. After this introduction, Anil talked about the well-oiled wrestlers. So after the introduction, when Anil took the introduction of Hari, the thief, they talked about the wrestling or the wrestlers. Anil talked about the well-oiled wrestlers who were grunting. Grunting means shouting, lifting and throwing each other about. So they were talking about the wrestlers, how their body is oiled and how they are grunting and how they are lifting to each other and throwing each other about. I didn't have much to say. Anil walked away. The thief didn't speak much and Anil walked away. I followed casually and the thief followed the Anil. Hello again, he said. Then the thief again said hello to Anil. I gave him my most appealing smile. Then he gave him a smile. I want to work for you, I said, but I can't pay you. So the thief asked him that he wanted to work for him. Then the Anil replied, but he couldn't pay him. I thought that over for a minute, perhaps I had misjudged my manner. So he thought for a minute, the thief thought for a minute, and he thought that he was not the right person to choose, or he had misjudged this man. I asked, can you feed me? Then the thief asked to Anil that can he feed him? Then the Anil asked, can you cook? I can cook, I lied again. So the thief said, yes, I can cook, but he lied again because he didn't know how to cook. If you can cook, then maybe I can feed you. So then Anil said, if you can cook for me, so then I can feed you. He took me to his room over the Jamna sweet shop and told me I could sleep on the balcony. So the Anil took the thief to his room, which was over the Jamna sweet shop, and told him that he could sleep on the balcony. But the meal I cooked that night must have been terrible because Anil gave it to a stray dog. So as we know that the thief was not a good cook, so when that night he cooked something for Anil, which was very terrible, awful, and the Anil gave it to a stray dog. He didn't eat the food and told me to be off, and he said to the thief to get out from his home. But I just hung around. He just stood around, smiling in my most appealing way, and still he was smiling in his most pleasing way because he wanted to live more with Anil. And he couldn't help laughing. And Anil couldn't help himself laughing. Later he patted me on the head and said, never mind. Afterwards he patted on his head and said, never mind. He would teach me to cook, and said that he would teach him cooking. He also taught me to write my name and said he would soon teach me to write whole sentences and to add numbers. The Anil also taught the thief to write his name and said him he would soon teach him to write whole sentences and to add numbers. I was grateful. The thief was very grateful. I knew that once I could write like an educated man, there would be no limit to what I could achieve. So because the thief was thinking, if he able to write and write like an educated man, then he could be more professional, he could be more successful in his field of stealing things. It was quite pleasant working for Anil. So the thief is saying he was very happy to work for Anil. I made the tea in the morning and then would take my time buying the day's supplies. Then first in the morning he make tea for Anil, then afterwards he go to buy the daily needs, usually making a profit of about a rupee a day. So daily he get 1 rupee as a profit. I think he knew I made a little money this way, but he didn't seem to mind. The Anil knew about the 1 rupee profit he is getting daily, but he never questioned about that rupee. Anil made money by fits and start. Anil earned the money by fits and start. Fits and start means in an irregular way. The money which Anil earned is not fixed. He would borrow 1 week, lend the next week. 1 week he borrowed the money from somebody and next week he paid the money. He kept worrying about the next check. He always keep worrying about the next check, next money. But as soon as it arrived, he would go out and celebrate. And at the moment he get the money and he arrived and he celebrate. It seems he wrote for magazine. So by this we can say that it seems that Anil worked for magazine. Anil is a writer. He writes for magazines. A queer way to make a living. A strange way to earn money. One evening he came home with a small bundle of notes. So one evening the Anil came to home with a small bundle of notes saying he had just sold a book to the publisher, and he said to thief that he had sold a book to publisher. At night I saw him tuck the money under the mattress. At night the thief kept watching him and he saw that Anil was keeping the money under the mattress. I had been working for Anil for almost a month and apart from cheating on the shopping, had not done anything in my life, in my line of work. So the thief had been working with Anil for almost a month. He didn't do cheating. He was just cheating during the time of shopping, just a rupee from the daily needs. Apart from it, he didn't done any kind of cheating or stealing from Anil's house. I had every opportunity for doing so. Anil had given me a key to the door. The narrator is saying, the thief is saying that he had all the opportunity to do the stealing because the Anil had given him a key to the door. And I could come and go as I pleased. He was the most trusting person I had ever met. The thief said he was very trusting person. The Anil was very trusting person. He had never met such type of person in whole life. And that is why it was difficult to rob him. Because of Anil's trust on him, it was so difficult for the thief to rob Anil. It is easy to rob a greedy man because he can afford to be robbed. According to the thief, it is easy to rob a greedy man or a rich man because they had a lot of money and which they kept hidden. But it is difficult to rob a careless man. Sometimes he doesn't even notice he has been robbed, and that makes all the pleasure out of the work. On the other side, robbing a careless person like Anil didn't make much difference because he might not even notice that he has been robbed, and that took all the excitement or thrill from the work that is stealing. Well, it's time I did some real work, I told myself. Then the thief justify himself that he must do some real work, that is the stealing things. I'm out of practice, and if I don't take the money, he'll only waste it on his friends. After all, he doesn't even pay me. Then he thought, if he didn't steal the money from Anil, then he would waste the money on his friends. And after all, Anil didn't pay for his work what he did. Anil was asleep. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony and fell on the bed. So it was the night time and Anil was sleeping, and the beam of moonlight, and it was a moonlight outside, and it stepped over the balcony. The moonlight was falling on the balcony and as well as on the bed. I sat up on the floor considering the situation, and the narrator and the thief, he sat on the floor and wondered, he was thinking about the plan, what would he do after taking all the money. If I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. So the thief was planning. What was he planning? He thought that if he took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. Then he could catch the train to Lucknow, sleeping out of the blanket. He quietly moved from the blanket. I crept up to the bed, and he crept to the pastures of creep, and he Without making any sound, he slightly moves towards the bed. Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined. And Anil's face was clear and unlined. There were no tension on his face and he was sleeping peacefully. Even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. Then he was comparing his face with Anil's face. He was saying that on his face there were more lines as well as scars. My hand slid under the mattresses. Then the thief said he slid his hand under the mattress where the Anil put his money. Searching for the notes when I found them, and he was searching the notes when he found them, I drew them out without sound. And got the notes, and he drew them out without making any kind of sound. Anil sighed in his sleep and turned on his side. While he was taking out the money, Anil took a deep breath and turned his face towards thief. I was startled and quickly crawled out of the room. And the narrator, the thief, he shocked and quickly he crawled. Crawled means he ran on his knee out of the room. When I was on the road, I began to run. And when the narrator was on the road and he started running, I had the notes at my waist. And where did he keep the notes? He kept the notes on his waist, held there by the string of my pajamas. And he kept the notes under the pajamas, inside the pajama, and tied it with the help of the strings. I slowed down to a walk and counted the notes. Then afterwards, as he was running, he slowed down and he counted the notes. 600 rupees in 50s. And it was 600 rupees, and all the notes were of 50 rupees. I could live like an old rich Arab for a week or two. And he thought that he could live like an old rich Arabian merchant for a week or two. Means he could spend a luxurious life for 2 or 1 week. When I reached the station, I did not stop at the ticket office. I had never bought a ticket in my life, but I dashed straight to the platform. Dashed means move quickly. So when the thief reached the station, he didn't stop at the ticket office and he directly went to the platform because he was not in the habit of buying the tickets for traveling. He always used to travel without ticket. The Lucknow Express was just moving out. The moment he reached the platform, the Lucknow Express was about to move. The train had still to pick up speed, but the train was not in the good speed. It had to take the speed, and I should have been able to jump into one of the carriages. The speed is that much efficient, so the narrator could have been able to jump into one of the carriages, but I hesitated. The narrator hesitated for some reason I can't explain. But the narrator hesitated to get into the carriages, one of the carriages. But what was the reason of his hesitation? He himself was not aware. And I lost the chance to get away. And he lost the chance to escape. He lost the chance to get into the train. When the train had gone, I found myself standing alone on the deserted platform. When the train left the platform, he found himself standing alone on the deserted platform. Deserted means lonely, empty. I had no idea where to spend the night. And the train had left and he had no idea where to go to spend this night. I had no friends, believing that friends were more trouble than help. As he had no friends, he believes that friends were more trouble rather than helpful. And I did not want to make anyone curious by staying at one of the small hotels near the station. And he didn't want to stay in a small hotel nearby the station to become a part of attraction. The only person I knew really well was the man I had robbed. He knew only one person, Anil, to whom he had robbed. Leaving the station, I walked slowly through the bazaar. He was leaving the station and he walked off slowly through the bazaar. In my short career as a thief, I had made a studies study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. So while he was going through the bazaar, he was thinking about his career, he met a different type of people and what was the different type of reaction when he steal the things from the different people. I had made a study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. So he was saying that he could recognize the man's face when they lost their good or wealth. The greedy man showed fear. The greedy man, they showed fear on their faces. The rich man showed anger, and there were anger on the rich man's face when they lost their goods. The poor man showed acceptance. The poor man has a acceptance on his face. But I knew that Anil's face. Then his comparison, all these faces to the Anil's face. But he knew that Anil's face when he discovered the theft. When Anil came to know about the theft, would show only a touch of sadness. There would be only a touch of sadness, not for the loss of money, but for the loss of trust. The narrator was saying when the Anil came to know about the theft, he became sad. But that sadness was not because of he lost the money. That sadness was just he lost the trust which he did on the Hari Singh, the thief. I found myself in Medan and sat down on a bench. He found himself in a ground and he sat down on a bench. The night was chilly. It was early November. It was the month of early winter, November. It was a cold. And a light drizzle added to my discomfort. As it was cold and it started, light drizzle. Drizzle means small drops of rain. Soon it was raining quite heavily. As soon as the drizzle turned into the heavy rain. My shirt and pajamas stuck to my skin. Due to the heavy rain, his clothes were stuck on his skin. And the cold wind blew rain across my face. And he was feeling very cold. I went back to the bazaar and sat down in the shelter of the clock tower. So the thief, he went back to the bazaar and sat down under the clock tower to take the shelter because it was raining. The clock showed midnight and he saw the clock and it was midnight. I fell for the notes. Then he was thinking about the notes. He thought about the notes. They were damp from the rain and those notes were damp due to rain. Anil's money. In the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. Then I was thinking, this was while looking at the Anil's money. Then he was thinking in the morning, he would probably have given him 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. But now I had it all. But now he was saying that he had all his money. I couldn't cook his meals, run to the bazaar and learn to write whole sentences anymore. And he was thinking now he could not cook meal for Anil. And he could not go to the grocery shop to buy the daily needs. And he could not learn even the sentences as Anil promised him to make him educated man. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of the theft. Now the thief was thinking I had forgotten that he want to learn and write. Just because in the excitement of the theft, whole sentences. I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. Whole sentences, he was saying he knew that whole sentences could one day bring him more than 500 rupees. Being an educated man, he can earn more than these 100 rupees. It was a simple matter to steal, and sometimes just a simple to be caught, but to be a really big man. Then he said, it was simple matter to steal, and sometimes just as simple to be caught. He's saying stealing is as simple as, and being caught is also just a very simple. But to be really big man, a clever, respected man was something else. But a really big man, a clever and respected man is something different. I should go back to Anil, I told myself, if only to learn to read and write. Then he told himself that he should go back to Anil if only he wants to read and write. I hurried back to the room feeling very nervous. So the thief decided he would go back to the Anil's house and again he'll started learning. I hurried back to the room feeling very nervous. So he hurriedly back to the room and he was very nervous. For it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. Because it was very easy to steal something rather than return it without noticed. I opened the door quietly and then stood in the doorway. He quietly opened the door and stood nearby the doorway. In a clouded moonlight, still it was the night time and it was clouded moonlight. Anil was still asleep and Anil was still sleeping. I crept to the edge of the bed. He moved towards the bed and my hand came up with the notes. I felt his breath on my hand and he kept the money under the mattress and he felt Anil's breath on his hand. I remained still for a minute, then my hand found the edge of the mattress. It was a night time, he can't see the edge of the mattress. So with the help of hand, he was finding the edge of the mattress and slipped it with the notes. When he found the edge of the mattresses, he put the money under the mattress. I awoke late next morning. He stretched out his hand towards me. He put forward his hand towards Hari Singh thief. There was a 50 rupees note between his fingers and there were a note of 50 rupees between his finger. My heart sank. I thought I had been discovered. So the thief thought that Anil caught him and he found him he had stolen his rupees. I made some money yesterday, he explained. Then Anil said, yesterday he had earned some money. Now you will be paid regularly. Now he would be paid regularly. My spirits rose, but when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. He was happy after listening all this, Anil said he would be paid regularly. But when I took the note, I saw it was wet from the night's rain. When he took the note, he observed that the note was still wet due to the night's rain. Today we'll start writing sentences, he said. Then Anil said today he would teach him to write sentences. He knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. He knew everything, all the incident, what happened last night. But neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. But he didn't say anything to Hari. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way. Then the Hari Singh, the thief, he smiled at Anil in his most appealing way, in most pleasing way. And the smile came it by itself without any effort. So this time there was no any curiosity. There was no any planning in his thief's mind. And the smile was genuine. And it came itself on his face without any effort. So student, this was a story of a two boy. One is Anil, one is Hari. And in the entire story, you see how the thief has changed his life after staying with Anil. Earlier he was a thief. Now he had become a good person. He had changed his life. He started to learn and write.